Hey, what's up everyone? Thanks for checking out the channel again. This is Shane from Sky High Reef. And just wanted to come in this week and give you a different type of update video on my tank. My tank is officially, at this point, 3.5 months old. I'm going through that stage now where the tank is finding its balance. It's really starting to get some good consumption from the alkalinity inside of the system. I'm still running the AquaForce components 1, 2, 3 for my dosing. So I'm pretty happy with the tank at this point in its life. So far I got a lot going on. I've been able to add a few more frags. I've added a torch coral, a few more SPS frags along the top, got some on a frag rack. I have another frag rack back here with about 8 frags on it. And for the most part, I'm starting to fill out the rock. A lot of times when you see reef tanks online on YouTube, you see a lot of tanks and they're set up with a lot of frag racks. For me, the goal is more so a beautiful display tank. With a display tank, it does take more time. You do really have to give it that year and a half to really grow out to get that effect. But with a frag tank, it's just a different type of vibe and it's just not for me. Having the rows and rows of corals, it's not really what I'm looking for. So even in my frag rack that I picked out one of the trees and it spreads around and I can move in, and it's just something that's abnormal and it's not something common that you would see, because I'm not looking for the same thing other people are trying to do. Long term, I want to have a big SPS dominant mixed reef. If you notice all along the top shelves here, I have a lot of the stacks rock that I combined with the Caribou Sea Life Shape rocks. So I have all my arches going along, and then I have cemented in stacks rocks going across the top. Some are balanced, some are cemented. That way it's kind of modular so I can move it when I do want to upgrade to another tank. But for the most part, this whole top level here is going to be all SPS. And the idea is to have my highlight corals over here, all of my tenuouses and really nice stuff right under the lights here. I can grow some other corals SPS wise on this side. I'm running the T5 combo with the Aqua Illumination Hydra 52. Down here in this middle section, the goal is going to be mostly LPS and Zoas. So if you notice, I've started dropping a lot of Acans in, I've dropped some encrusting Montes in, and then I have all my little specks of Zoas all over the place. Down here in this middle section, I want to do this all with my yellow-colored Monty. So I started off with the Jason Fox Beach Bum, plan on adding the Crazy Tea, plan on adding the Alter Ego, Kung Pao, things like that to give that nice gold color in this middle section, along with some torch corals, having the Zoas in the background, the Monty's growing around them. I think it'll give it a really nice look to the tank. Down here for this bottom half where I'm gonna have the sand bed, this area here, I wanna put a couple of scolies. I wanna have a nice elegance coral back here in the middle. Down here to the left, I wanna put some more, you know, plate corals, things like that. On that back section of the wall, there, it's all bare bottom. Coming across this arch right here, this is all bare bottom. So I have a patch of sand here underneath this rock, and I have a patch of sand going off to the side with the overflow. My idea was less sand, less maintenance, almost bare bottom, so I can go super high flow for the SPS corals that I plan long term on having this tank, and just trying to find that balance. Now, going through the cycle, this was a semi-tank transfer, so I didn't really go through a cycle per se, but it did have its swings. So I went through the fuzzy algae, I went through the dirty sand, I just getting through the cyanobacteria. So the tank is progressing pretty good. But being that I don't have as much sand, I am expecting for it to take a little bit longer to really find its place and really, you know, find its own balance in itself. They say with a bare bottom it takes about a year, so I'm figuring half and half. Around the 6-month mark, I should really find that good stable level for the system. I do plan on keeping this for at least the next year and a half, until I'm able to move or upgrade to a newer system, but I would like to keep all of these corals. So I have been cherry picking what I want. Obviously, I've been buying some filler pieces. I have lost a lot of my named corals, believe it or not. But as the game goes, I guess the more expensive it is, the more delicate it is. So I would, of course, lose those. But even my Jason Fox homeworker in the middle is receding a bit. Now, some people will start freaking out since that is such an expensive frag. But for me, this is a display tank. I'm not going to change everything to save one coral. If I lose that home wrecker, I lose that home wrecker. But if I don't lose all the rest of my SPS, then it's still a win. That's one coral out of 60, 70 pieces that I have in here, not counting heads. And that's kind of the ideology I'm going with this tank. I've been keeping reef tanks for a couple of years now, so I have developed the patience and understanding that this is something that's going to take a while. And as long as I give it the care and I'm aware of what's happening, they will eventually start growing. I will eventually have those colonies that I'm looking for. If you're wondering why am I in this video, well, the last video I posted, I had a comment where someone said, if you want to do exceptionally well, you need to find a way to basically show who you are, show the people who they're talking to. So I guess in my own way, I have to figure that out. So I tried to make a video with myself in it. I prefer the voiceovers, just like Deep Sleep Reef, CJ's Aquariums. I do like the voiceovers more so than being in the video, like, for example, an Inappropriate Reefer or a Jake from Reef Builders. That's more their style. I'm more of the narrator voiceover kind of guy, but I said, why not try it? Give it a try. I shot the video mostly with my T5s on. My Hydra is on as well. It's a T5 LED combo. I do have the filters on to make it a little brighter so that way you can also see me. I don't have microphones and things like that yet, so it's a little bit different to do the videos this way versus a voiceover, but why not give it a try? Maybe someone will see me, love me, and I'll be doing it this way forever. But for right now, I'm super happy. This past week, I was able to add a three-head torch down here. It's an Aussie variety. It's purple with the green tips. I was able to add a last dragonfly up there. I have a green branching digi that I just picked up. Hawkins back there. What else did I get? I got that WWC slime ball Anacaporo in the back. Tequila Sunrise Monte Poro down here. I was also to pick up from the same guy. I got a Motor City Mayhem Chalice. I also got a small little eye on the side of a frag plug growing. From the same collector, I have my Worldwide Corals Grafted Monty, the OG. Red Montes, Green Montes, Jedi Mind Trick Montes, all from the same guy. So this year I plan on buying a lot more corals locally. I probably spent less for all of that than I would if I bought one coral online. So I'm super happy. I'm getting great growth on my Pink Boobies Chalice down there. I was also able to add a Blasto Frag. So if that does well, Blastos are another thing I think I'm going to start adding. I want to have at least about 5 or 6 of them. So if this one does well, I'm going to start getting to more frags and just kind of dotting them along. Like I said, this middle section, I want it to be mostly ACANs, LPS, corals, zoas, just to give that base to the acros that are going to grow up. And that's the goal, and that's an update for this time. Hopefully you guys like this type of video. Hopefully over the next few weeks, I'm going to try and add some more fish into the system. My alkalinity consumption is out of control right now, so I'm super happy about that. I'm getting a lot of growth. I'm not getting the coloration that I once had yet, but with time, it's still a new tank, everything is still adjusting. But for right now, I'm really happy with the reef. Not having any major issues, so far so good. Hopefully you guys, like I said, like the video with me in it. Hopefully you find me beautiful, funny, entertaining, I don't know what. But here's your video with me in it. For the most part, I'll probably be going back to doing the voiceovers, but can't say you never saw me. So once again, guys, thanks for watching the video. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for all the likes and comments over the past 6 months that I started this YouTube channel. Go over to Instagram and check out Sky High Reef. I post a lot more frequently on there, mostly daily. I post in my story and whatnot. So give it a try, give it a look, give me a follow, subscribe. And thanks for watching, guys. Really appreciate it. I hope to see you back soon next time.